Most of the time, we don't have this transition function, and we don't have the reward function either. So the robot, or the trader, or whatever environment we're in, has to interact with the world, observe what happens, and work with that data to try to build a policy. So let me give you an example here. Let's say we were in state S1, so that's what we observed there. Our robot took action A1. I'm making this little subscript to indicate that which step in this series of steps it's at. We then find ourselves in S prime, and we get reward R. Now, this is an experience tuple. This is very similar to experience tuples in regression learning, where we have a X and a Y paired together. That's an experience tuple of, you know, when you observe this X, you see this Y. Here, we're saying when you observe this state S1, you take action A1, you end up in this new state, at least it's an example of you ending up in this new state, S1 prime, and reward R1. Now we find ourselves in a new state, S2, but that's really this state. It's where we found ourselves. We take some new action, A2. We end up in some new state, S2 prime, and we get a new reward, R2. And we do this over and over and over and over and over again, gathering experience tuples all along the way. Now, if we have this trail of experience tuples, there's two things we can do with them in order to find that policy pi. The first set of approaches is called model-based reinforcement learning. What we do is we look at this data over time, and we build a model of t just by looking statistically at these transitions. In other words, we can look at every time we were in a particular state and took a particular action and see which new states we ended up in, and just build a tabular representation of that. It's not hard. Similarly, we can build a model of R. We just look statistically when we're in a particular state and we take an action, what's the reward? And we can just average that over all these instances. Once we have these models, we can then use value iteration or policy iteration to solve the problem. There's another set of approaches called model-free, and that's the type that we're going to focus on. In particular, we're going to learn about Q-learning. And model-free methods develop a policy just directly by looking at the data. And of course, we'll talk about those soon.